I have been picking up quite a bit of additional eye supports in the last few days. Now it's time to rehome them. I started with just 5 specimens of Armadillidium vulgare. Now I have some more. Oh look, this one is molting. I like how they broke down this piece of sponge cloth. Much more faster than Nagurus cristatus, I think. Okay, time to take them out of their temporary enclosure. They also had a bit of cuttlefish bone, of course. Now the plan is to split the starter population in half. And I will do this by picking out some of the more colorful ones or those that have more of a pattern to them, like this one for instance. The good ones go into the pot, the bad ones, well, there are no bad ones. No isopod shaming, please. Well, this is it. The lighting is not so optimal, but you just have to believe me. Those are the ones that look more interesting, like this one, for example. It has a more pronounced pattern of yellow markings. This will be their new home. The substrate is old soil from my giant African land snail enclosure and a bit of compost and leaf litter and wood chips and so on. And of course I'm using the old sponge cloths of my glowworm enclosures, because as we have seen, they actually eat them, which makes perfect sense because they are composed of cellulose. Oh yeah, and you can have this cuttlefish bone also. As an additional calcium source, some eggshells. Some triops food as a treat. The rest of the collected individuals are put to work as a cleanup crew in the enclosure of the snails that I use as feeders for my glowworms. It's always somehow centered around glowworms with me. That's how it is. Now clean that up! I mean, enjoy your free food.